Gatwick is the world's second busiest international airport, with almost 20 million passengers in 1987. Last year, there were nearly 200,000 flights in and out, all on the airport's one single runway. The report says Gatwick is fast reaching maximum capacity and must have a second runway, but admits there'll be difficulties, obstacles and controversy before one is built, a project which would take at least 10 years. The row has already started. Villagers in Charlwood, to the north of Gatwick, fear 800 homes will be demolished if the new runway runs parallel to the existing one, the route favoured in the report. And there's anger that in 1979, the British Airports Authority and West Sussex County Council signed an agreement prohibiting a second runway for 40 years. Select committee members say a similar undertaking made to residents at Stansted Airport was altered, and the need for the runway must outweigh environmental concerns.
For a government to give an agreement that was going to last 40 years was crazy. And if the government had any sense, it would admit it was wrong and say, I'm sorry, we're going to overrule this and build a second runway. But obviously I'm concerned about people and their environment. I don't want to see people lose their homes. And the government has to make this decision.
500 air traffic controllers working at West Drayton, Heathrow, Gatwick and Stansted say they're badly understaffed, overworked and suffering from increasing levels of stress-related sickness. They've welcomed the report's recommendations but say near misses and delays won't end until they're implemented.
We will keep it safe, but you'll have to put up with delays at airports and spending more time in lounges at airports than on aircraft, which isn't very pleasant on your holidays, but it frankly is the only way to keep it safe for the next 6 or 7 years.
Other recommendations include the possibility of more night flights at Heathrow and better use of Stansted and Luton. Kerry Swain, Thames News.